Well, hey there. My name is Nicole Mace with Leveraging E-Learning, and this is a channel where I show you more tips and tricks and strategies to help you teach more effectively and with heart online. So, in this video, I want to show you how to create a weighted grade course structure in your Canvas course. The best part about it is I'm going to teach you how to do this in just 4 steps. The first thing we want to really understand is that this process is completely done in the assignment section of your Canvas course. So let's jump in. And here we have the assignments. Now I want to make it really clear. Any type of learning activity where you have set that it is graded with a certain number of points is going to show up in your assignments tab. This would be for a quiz that has points, an assignment, or even a discussion. Again, any learning activity that has points associated with it. So now that we're in the assignment section of our course, our first step is to create the actual grade or category groups to assign a certain percentage to each group. So my 3 groups I'm going to have are assignments, so I'm going to leave this box, and here I'm going to add my second group, which I'm going to call this my assessments. These are going to be any type of assignment that is actually assessing if they are meeting a module or course objective. So assignments, and now assessments. I'm going to have one more grade group or grade category, and I'm going to make this for my discussions. And hit save. Great. Now I have 3 different grade categories or grade groups. Step number 2 is going to be to add those assignments to the correct group. Now, if you're in a course that already has the assignments created, such as the ones here, Canvas makes it super easy to place the correct assignment into the correct grade group. So, for example, I'm going to say that this quiz happens to be an assessment. So I'm going to hover over the 8 dots here, click drag and drop into my assessments grade group. My discussions, I want to put that, so click, drag, and drop into my discussions. So that's one way of adding your assignments into the correct grade group. If you are in the point of creating your assignments, there's a really easy drop-down menu when you're editing an assignment to add it to the correct grade group. I'll show you that now. So here we are in an assignment, and we are in the editing mode. So just below my big text box here are my assignment settings. And you're going to find these similar settings in assignments, discussions, and quizzes. The one setting you want to look for is called your assignment group. Next to the assignment group, you have a drop-down menu. So if I select on the drop-down menu, I can see those 3 different grade group or grade categories that I have created. So for this particular assignment, I'm going to make sure it goes into my assessments. And there you have it. This assignment is now going to be stored in my assessments grade group. So looking back in my assignments tab with my 3 different grade groups, I can see that I have assignments in my assignment group, assignments in my assessment group, and assignments in my discussion group. So that is step number 2, adding the assignments to the correct grade group. Step 3 is assigning the correct percentage to each of the grade groups. So we'll start that procedure by selecting the triple dots in the top right corner, selecting the assignment group's weight, and here Canvas gives you the checkbox to assume the course structure that you now want to have specific grade groups in your grade book. So weight final grade based on these assignment groups. I'm going to check mark that, and now I can see my 3 different grade groups with the percentage options here. So of course the total needs to equal 100. So now I'll distribute the percentage based on how much these assignment groups are worth in the total grade. My largest assessment points are going to be associated with my assessments because those are going to be worth the most to create the total grade. These assignments are going to be the ones that show me if students are meeting the course objectives. So for this one here, I'm going to say it's worth maybe 50% of their grade are going to be all the assessments in the course together. With 50 points left in the total grade, I'm going to say assignments are worth 30% and discussions are worth 20%. So there we have it, our 100% in the grade. That means any assignments that are in this assessments category or grade group is going to be worth 50% of student grade, assignments are worth 30%, and discussions are worth 20%. So this is step three, setting that the course structure is going to be a weighted grade course structure, and then entering the percentage for each grade group. I'll select save. Wonderful. Now we have each grade group, we have the assignments that fall in that grade group, and we have the percentage that equals a total grade, 30% here, 50% here, and 20% here. The fourth and final step is to go ahead and look in your gradebook and see how this has given you a separate column for these grade groups. So let's check that out now. I'm going to select grades. And I don't have any current students in this course, but I can see my assignments here. My assignment grade groups are actually found at the end of my grade group. So I'm going to scroll all the way to the end, and you'll see the three columns just before the total are my grade group categories. So assignments, you'll be given an easy percentage to see how students are doing in your assignments category, in the assessments category, and in the discussions category. The great thing for students is that they will also have these categories in their own grade center. So they can check and see, I'm doing great in assignments and assessments, but maybe I'm falling a little behind on discussions. So it's easy for them to assess how they're doing in each of these grade categories. Now, two more things I want to leave you with. One is to make sure that these grade categories are listed on your syllabus so students know exactly how their grade percentages are being distributed. The last thing I want to leave you with in this video is to explain how well this works when you're adding new assignments to your Canvas course. So let's say I'm in week one and I realize right off the bat that students are having a difficult time with a specific concept in that module one learning. So what I can do is, being a flexible instructor, I can add a support element or a support assignment in module two to help students develop that concept. So I can do that very easily without worrying about ruining my point scheme that's going to add my total grade, because all of my assignments are in specific grade groups. So I can do that by just adding an assignment or adding an element to this module. Maybe it's going to be an assignment where we're asked to do a little bit more work on that specific concept. It's going to be a new assignment. I'm going to look at my numbers here. Maybe it's going to be 2.5, and I can go ahead and move this wrap up to 2.6. So I'm going to say, just call this, for the video's sake, added assignment. All right, so easily I can move this up to the correct area. I'm going to change this quickly to 2.6, and I love how once you change it in one place in Canvas, it's going to be changed in all places in Canvas. I'm going to click into that graded assignment, go to my edit button, and once I've constructed the assignment using the text box here and all of my formatting and additional resources, I'm going to go down here and go to my assignment group, and I'm going to make sure that this is not in the assessments or discussion, it's in the assignments grade group. And so the points that I add for this assignment, it really doesn't matter because this assignment is still going to fall in that 30% assignment group for assignments. So it's really easy and really great to be able to add and subtract assignments or even extra credit opportunities, knowing that it's not going to throw off my entire grading scheme because assignments are still going to be weighted according to the percentages that you have set. So I hope this really helps you out in understanding how weighted grades will really help you out being more flexible in your course. You don't have to worry about adding up to one total grade for points because you're working with percentages. Please let me know if you have any questions by leaving a comment down below, and let me know if this is going to help you out for setting up your Canvas course. And as always, if you have any questions about how to teach college online with purpose and ease, please let me know. You can always send me an email at hello@leveragingelearning.com. Don't forget to check out other resources I have at leveragingelearning.com to support my fellow colleagues in teaching college courses online. Bye for now.